Here, cat means a big cat like this cheetah. Usually, we use the word cat, it goes with a regular cat. But when we use the expression big cats are cheetahs, leopards, lions, and tigers. So, how does it start? Cat conundrum. Cat conundrum. What is the meaning of the word conundrum? It means a confusing and difficult problem or question. So, why is this a difficult problem or question? What does it mean? It means that on the one hand, we have big cats like lion, tiger, which are endangered. And on the other hand, we want to introduce a big cat like cheetah. So this results in a confusing and difficult problem to handle. India misses its cheetahs, but the priority must be to preserve the existing species. India misses its cheetahs. In fact, cheetah was declared extinct in our country. It became extinct in the 20th century. So obviously, India misses its cheetahs, but the priority must be to preserve the existing species. So this sentence talks about the focus must be on preserving the existing species or the endangered species instead of introducing cheetahs. There is one helping verb. Whenever you read a sentence, try to learn the words. That is one thing you have to focus on, new words. The other thing, you should recollect whatever grammar you have learned. There's one helping verb here, must. Must has two functions. One is to express personal obligation. The other one, to convey the idea that something is compulsory. So it must be, the priority must be to preserve the existing species. Existing species. One word, preserve. Preserve means conserve or protect. And species, it goes with plants and animals. Species means a plant species or animal species, a class. The Supreme Court's order enabling the introduction of exotic cheetahs to an Indian habitat on an experimental basis has naturally led to renewed enthusiasm among wildlife lovers who see in it a potential bulwark against creeping pressures on habitats. This sentence talks about the response from the wildlife enthusiasts. Obviously, the wildlife enthusiasts, they feel very happy because they are going to introduce cheetahs into the wild habitats. And one of the reasons why they feel very happy, it has a potential to bulwark. Bulwark means to act as a defensive wall against creeping pressures on habitats. Here, to look at the grammar point, there is one expression, has naturally led. The verb here is led. Has naturally led means what? It is in present perfect tense. In this editorial, many sentences are in present perfect, a few are in past passive voice, and a few sentences in present tense. So this sentence talks about the response of the wildlife enthusiasts and why they're happy. One of the reasons, it acts as a defensive wall against creeping pressures on habitats. There are a few words which are really important. Exotic. Exotic part of speech, adjective. It goes with species, flora, fauna. It also goes with locations. We say exotic species, exotic locations, or exotic locales. So exotic means what? Non-native, foreign, unusual. All these words could be used. And do remember, it is an adjective. The word combinations are exotic species, exotic plants, exotic animals, exotic fauna, exotic flora. Besides these typical combinations, exotic also goes with locations. When we talk about the film industry, those people quite often use the expression exotic locales. Locale is a short form of location. Then there's one important word that goes with this context. I call it a lexical term. What is this lexical term in this editorial? Habitat. Habitat means natural dwelling of a particular, natural dwelling or place of a particular plant or animal. Animals live in a particular area, in a particular environment, or a particular ecosystem. That is known as habitat. And there's one more word, enthusiasm. You all must be knowing enthusiasm means what? Eagerness. Bulwark, that's an important word. Bulwark, one meaning, from a layman's point of view, a defensive wall. Another meaning of bulwark, fortification. But here you can remember this as a defensive wall against what? Creeping pressures on habitats. Creeping animals. Creep means move slowly. So here, creeping pressure, slowly the pressure is being built on the habitats. It talks about that. As a graceful animal that was hunted, this is in past tense, passive voice, as a graceful animal. Graceful means elegant. As a graceful animal that was hunted and extirpated, this is again an important word, in the country in the 20th century. This animal became extinct in the 20th century, and extirpated talks about that. What is the meaning of the word extirpate? It's a regular verb. The past form is extirpated. It means eradicate completely. So a cheetah was eradicated completely from the habitat in our country, and it became extinct. The cat has periodically inspired campaigns for a fresh introduction, mainly inspired by the nationalistic sense of loss. So many a time, a lot of campaigns have been taken up to reintroduce the cheetah into the Indian wild habitats. One of the reasons for that, nationalistic sense of loss. So Indians feel that cheetah belongs to them and they have been, it has been lost, and they wanted that animal to be introduced into the wild habitats in our country. Remarkably, and there is one expression here, the cat has periodically inspired. Periodically is an adverb, has inspired. This is again in present perfect tense. Remarkably, the antiquity of the high-speed hunter that formed part of Mughal hunting groups has been a matter of scientific debate, with much literature tracing the origins of the Asiatic cheetah to about 2 lakh years ago. A very lengthy sentence. Do remember, whenever you come across a lengthy sentence, you have to look at the subject and you have to isolate the phrases and the clauses that go with that particular subject, and what is the main idea you have to, you should try to get it. Though it is a lengthy sentence, it talks about the origin of this particular animal is rather debatable, debate, controversial. Because what is the reason? How does the writer substantiate? Because on the one hand, it talks about 2 lakh years, and on the other hand, the recent studies say, and one recent hypothesis arguing in contrast, that it appears to be a relatively modern alien import to India. On the one hand, 2 lakh years ago, introduction of this animal into the Indian habitat. On the other hand, the recent studies says it appears to be a relatively modern alien import to India. Such a lengthy sentence. Do remember, nowadays, in competitive exams, off late, they have been giving lengthy sentences. Whenever you come across a lengthy sentence, you have two problems. One problem, you need a lot of time to read the sentence. For that, you got to be a fast reader. On the other hand, to understand the context, a lengthy sentence, it is not that easy. The context should be familiar. If the context is familiar, you will be able to understand effortlessly. Let us have a look. What does it talk about? This sentence talks about, remarkably, the antiquity. Antiquity means what? Great age or the distant past. This sentence talks about the antiquity of this particular animal, the cat, the big cat, the cheetah. Remarkably, the antiquity of the high-speed hunter that formed part of Mughal hunting groups has been a matter of scientific debate. Has been. This is also in present perfect, but the word been, it is a past participle of the primary auxiliary to be. This is a bit difficult to understand. A lot of students find it difficult to handle questions related to the primary auxiliary be, and the past participle form of that is been. It has been. Here we have used the primary auxiliary as a main verb, and the sentence is in present perfect. Has been a matter of what? Has been a matter of scientific debate. Why? With much literature tracing the origins of the Asiatic cheetah to about 2 lakh years ago, on the one hand. The cat is, and one recent hypothesis arguing, in contrast, on the other hand, that it appears to be a relatively modern alien import to India. There's one word, hypothesis. It means suppose someone's theory, someone's idea, but without any evidence. Then we use the word hypothesis. And what is the other word here? Alien. Alien means unfamiliar. Usually alien goes with extraterrestrial life or an animal or a species that comes from space. We use the word alien. In this context, alien means unfamiliar. With a group surviving in Iran, there's growing interest in preserving the Asian population. Now, many wild animals have become endangered, on the verge of becoming extinct. The same thing goes with cheetah also. The sentence talks about a small group surviving in Iran. There's growing interest in preserving the Asian population. So Iran is part of Asian continent, so there's growing interest in preserving the Asian population of cheetahs. Whatever its origins, it is illogical to expect that a new population, whether from Africa or Iran, will fare better today than in the past. This sentence talks about the prospects. What are the chances for this big cat to survive, irrespective of its origin? Whatever its origins, that doesn't matter. It is illogical to expect that a new population of cheetahs, whether from Africa or Iran, will fare better today than in the past. Here there's one word, fare. Fare has many meanings. When you travel, you ask the question, how much is the fare from this place to that place? That talks about the cost of traveling. But in this context, fare means get along, survive, exist, a different meaning altogether. It is worth recalling that the same quote observed, why this question, here the sentence talks about, irrespective of the origin, whatever its origins, it is illogical to expect that a new population, whether from Africa or Iran, will fare better today than in the past. Why this question? It is worth recalling, the editorial talks about what happened in the past. It is worth recalling that the same court observed in its 2013 order restraining the Environment Ministry from importing African cheetahs into Kuno, Madhya Pradesh, that there are many seriously threatened Indian species, such as the lion, the great Indian bustard, Bengal florican, the dugong, and Manipur broe-antlered deer, which deserve immediate conservation action. So this sentence talks about whether it survives or not, that's a different thing, but we should always look at what is the existing situation. And the editorial provides what happened in 2013 as an insight, the court observation. The court observed that in 2013, restraining, they wanted to think twice before introducing new animals into the Indian habitat. One of the reasons, there are so many animals which are endangered, which are threatened, like lion, the great Indian bustard, Bengal florican, the dugong, a marine animal. So it talks about that. Coming to this sentence, there's one word which is worth learning, restrain, restraining. Prevent from doing something. Restrain yourself from doing something means what? Hold yourself, prevent yourself from doing something. Any move to rewild India's threatened natural spaces with cheetahs, which require large grassland ranges, should consider the viability of such a program. So again, it talks about being cautious. Any move to rewild India's threatened natural spaces with cheetahs, which require, these animals require large grassland ranges, should consider the viability of such a program. Viability means feasibility. So it talks about one has to consider, should is again a helping verb. It is used to advise or suggest someone, should consider the viability of such a program. Why should we think of the feasibility or the viability of such a program? He gives a reason. Man-animal conflicts is an area of concern as a growing human population lives cheek by jowl with tigers, leopards, and long-ranging creatures such as elephants. So it gives the, it tries to justify why we have to be, we have to look at the feasibility or viability of such a program. Man-animal conflicts is an area of concern. Today we come across the conflicts between the man and the animals, especially the wild animals and the big cats. As a growing human population lives cheek by jowl, that's an idiomatic expression which means close together. They live cheek by jowl means close together. And man lives close together with tigers, leopards, and long-ranging creatures such as elephants. While the court has appointed an expert committee to guide and direct the experiment proposed by the National Tiger Conservation Authority, it needs a broader scientific inquiry into the added pressures that a small group of introduced predators will impose on an ecosystem, crucially on the prey base that currently sustains tigers and leopards. So what does it talk about? The court has appointed an expert committee to guide and direct the experiment. What is the experiment here? Introducing the cheetahs. Proposed by the National Tiger Conservation Authority. This proposal, introducing cheetahs, has come from National Tiger Conservation Authority. So it talks about the need for a broader scientific inquiry into the impact that is going to make, into the added pressures that a small group of introduced predators, here predator means hunter. When we talk about animals, broadly we have three groups. One is predators, The other is prey. And the third one is scavengers. So cheetah is a predator. Lion is a predator. Tiger is a predator. And introduce the predators will impose on an ecosystem. What will be the impact of the introduction of these predators on an ecosystem? Especially, crucially means decisively. Crucial, important, decisive. On the prey base that currently sustains tigers and leopards. So what will be the impact on the prey base? Every animal has its own prey. And when we introduce a new species, the prey base of a particular animal may get affected. In this context, the prey base that sustains, supports tigers and leopards. Any attempt at expensive rewilding will be negated by parallel efforts to liberalize environmental clearances for extractive industries in and around forests. This again talks about a contrasting situation, a paradoxical situation. What is that? On the one hand, we are trying to introduce a wild animal, a big cat like cheetah. On the other hand, we try to, in the name of modernization, we liberalize environmental clearances. That results in a sort of conflict. Or that will nullify, negate, that's a good word. It means what? That will make all this ineffective, or it will nullify the impact of reintroducing the cheetahs into the wild. Material extraction, including minerals, is going on. Here is going on. This is in present continuous. In the previous sentence, any attempt at expensive rewilding will be negated. It will negate, active voice, will be negated, passive voice. When you read the sentences, do remember, you have to focus on three things. First, what is the meaning of this particular sentence? Second, how many new words are there? And third, what is the grammar used in this particular sentence? That in my opinion, that is a holistic approach. When you try to learn that way, what happens? On the one hand, you learn a lot of words. On the other hand, you will be able to consolidate your grammar knowledge. So material extraction, including minerals, is going on, present continuous tense, close to protected areas. And fresh roads are sought to be built through even tiger territory, making pristine rewilding an incongruous concept. It talks about you try to do something, you try to introduce a wild species. On the other hand, you try to, in the name of modernization, you go very close to these habitats and you try to spoil the pristine environment, which cannot be justified. There is one word here, pristine, means unspoiled. And one more word, important word, incongruous. Incongruous means what? Not in harmony. Moreover, cheetahs are genetically fragile and lose cubs in a litter prematurely, affecting the establishment of a viable population. It also talks about the limitations that go with this wild species, the cheetahs. That is, they are genetically fragile. Fragile means delicate, one meaning, and the related words are brittle. But usually brittle goes with things easily breakable. Here, fragile means delicate. Cheetahs are genetically fragile and lose cubs in a litter prematurely. Litter means a young one animal. Imagine there's a particular animal and it gives birth to about 5 or 6 cubs. All the cubs together, we use the word litter. That is one meaning. But litter has another meaning. What is the other meaning of litter? Litter also means the waste material, whatever you throw, the papers, all that stuff, garbage, litter. So lose cubs in a litter prematurely, affecting the establishment of a viable population, feasible population. Restoring ecology and diverse species cannot be a serious goal in the absence of ironclad protections to existing parks, sanctuaries, migratory corridors, and buffer areas. This sentence reiterates what the editorial talks about. Restoring ecology and diverse species cannot be a serious goal. You cannot do it in the absence of ironclad protections to existing parks, sanctuaries, migratory corridors, and buffer areas. First, we have to protect these. Then we should think of introducing a wild species. That's what the sentence talks about. And preserving wild spaces with surviving species should be the first order priority. It concludes on a suggestive note. Preserving wild spaces with surviving species should be the first order priority. First, we should focus on endangered species in our country and preserving wild spaces in our country. Then we should think of introducing new species. That's what the rule says or talks about. And there's one word here, buffer. Buffer, you all must be knowing. Usually when it comes to a video, we use the word buffer. In this context, buffer means what? A person or thing that reduces a shock between man and animal or between animals, whatever it is. A person or thing that reduces a shock. That's all for today from this editorial. Now it is time to work on the exercises and enrichment. As usual, we'll start with words and meanings. I will give you a minute, have a look and respond. Take one word at a time. I'll see your responses. I'll say right or wrong. Then the next word, then the next word. Don't skip the words and try to get the correct order. That is very important. Now it is time for you guys to respond, interact, and enrich your knowledge based on the editorial, today's editorial. I'll say the word, then you respond. The first word here, conundrum. Conundrum means what? What is the meaning of conundrum? It is, Ravi says, conundrum, unspoiled, distant past, get along. Where is this? G. That is G. Don't go to 8. Ravi, my request, take the first word. Let us do in a systematic way. That will help everyone. I appreciate your enthusiasm, but I request, take the first one, conundrum. What is the meaning of that? That would be better. Go through the entire list and try to make out. Fine, I'll wait for a minute. If you guys don't respond, then I will write the answer. I'll give the meaning, I'll write, then you can go to the next word. Conundrum means a problem or a puzzle. Something like a problem, difficult to handle, a puzzle, difficult to handle. The editorial starts with cat conundrum, means what? A problem or a puzzle. So what is the answer here? For this it is G. G is what? I will underline problem. Then you can make out what has been taken and what has to be taken. Now answer my question. What is the meaning of the word bulwark? That's an important word, not a regular word. Bulwark means what? You may not see the same word what I have given, but you should guess and make out the exact option. Bulwark, I gave the meaning a defensive wall. You may not see that, but you have to get the synonym. I may bring a synonym here, introduce a synonym. The meaning of bulwark, it means fortification. Fortification means what? To act as a defensive wall. So what is the answer here? I. Now what is the meaning of extirpate? That is again an important word you may get in a passage in the exam. Extirpate means what? Extirpate means eradicate. So what is the answer for extirpate? Eradicate. So what is the letter I'm supposed to write here? Extirpate, the big cat, means what? Eradicate. So what is the meaning of the word antiquity? That is right, Shiv Shankar. 3-1. This, I appreciate, who is this Ranjan? All of you, please write the word number and the letter. That makes things crystal clear. So Ranjan has written 3-1. 3 is what? Extirpate. But 3-I. So 3-I means what? Extirpate. But that is the answer. Extirpate means what? Eradicate. 3-F is the answer. Eradicate. Ganesh, that is the right answer. Now, what is the meaning of antiquity? If you respond when I say the word, it becomes easy for me to understand which one you're talking about. That is right. Antiquity, Satish says, distant past, absolutely. So what is the answer here? B is the answer. What is the meaning of fair? In this context, four is what? Fair means what? Fair means get along. C is the answer. Not unspoiled. Fair means, how does it fare? Means, does it get along? Does it survive? That is the meaning. What is the meaning of idiomatic expression cheek by jowl? Cheek by jowl means what? D, that is right. Who is this? Satish. Perfect. What is the meaning of cheek by jowl? Close together. No. Go to the next one. Seventh one, negated. Negated, what is the answer? Negated, 6D over 7, what is the answer? Negated. Ah, 6 is over. That is right. Cheek by jowl, close together, D. That is over. Now I want you guys to answer the next one. Negated. Negated means what? Optimus Prime, your answer is correct, but please go to the next one. Seven is negated, J, that is correct. Negated means what? Nullify. Satish, your answer is right. Who is that? Ravi, yes. A lot of students have given the correct answer, nullify. That's wonderful. What is the meaning of the word pristine? This is also an important word. It's a lexical term. Unspoiled, that is correct. Ganesh. And unspoiled, which option is that? A. 7J, wonderful. A lot of students have got it right. Please go to the 8th one. What is the meaning of pristine? Pristine means what? Unspoiled. Yes, Ganesh, your answer is right. One more student has given the correct answer for the 8th one. Pristine, unspoiled. Now please go to the next one. Optimus Prime, that is correct. 8A. What is the meaning of incongruous? Incongruous means what? I want the answer for the 9th one. Not in harmony. Optimus, your answer is correct. Incongruous means not in harmony. So what is the answer here? H, 9H. Ganesh, your answer is correct. 8A, that is right, Satish. Go to the next one, 9th one. Some students have already answered. Yes, Aman, that is correct. 8A, Chenchulakshmi, that is correct. Pristine, unspoiled. 10th one, Ganesh says, fragile, delicate, absolutely. What is the answer? 10th one, fragile means what? Delicate. What is a related word? Fragile, we also use the word, you should recollect the word brittle. But brittle usually goes with things, easily breakable. Eggshells, glass, eggshells are brittle, glass is brittle. Fragile environment, fragile habitat. These are the typical combinations. Yes, Nandu, brittle, correct. You have done well. I appreciate all the students who have participated. It shows how attentive you are, how alert you are, and to what extent you remember, based on the editorial, you could respond immediately. That is highly appreciable. I haven't given enough time, but you listened to me once, and you could recollect and get the almost all right. Now, I will give you a minute or 2 minutes. A very short passage, closed test. There are 5 blanks. Read the sentence, understand the context, and try to recollect from the editorial. Try to use the exact word. When you try to do that, think of the lexical terms, think of the context. Also use your grammar knowledge. That also helps when it comes to closed test. Yes, Ravi, breakable. That is right. Brittle. Already Optimus says the one exotic. I'll be doing every day, Ganesh. Every day morning 7, I'm going to do this. Every day with exercises, same editorial. This is today's editorial. My pleasure. So what is the first word here? The Supreme Court's order enabling the introduction of cheetahs. First, you have to look at the word after the blank. What is the word after the blank, cheetahs? That is a noun. Then you should tell yourself the word before a noun, usually adjective. So what is the adjective here? How do you describe animals? Beautiful, wonderful, dangerous, aggressive. And one word is there. One student has responded with the correct word. Answer is exotic. Introduction of exotic cheetahs. Unfamiliar, strange, unusual. That is correct. Pia, your answer is right. Nandu, your answer is right. Ganesh, your answer is right. Optimus has gone to the fifth one. Optimus, please give others also. We'll do in a systematic way. Let others also respond. One blank at a time. First one, exotic. Absolutely right. Then continue reading. Get the second word. The Supreme Court's order enabling the introduction of exotic cheetahs to an Indian habitat on an experimental basis has naturally led to renewed what? Yes, Atul. First one, exotic, I have written already. Second one, Yadav says enthusiasm. Let others also respond. Definitely, I will do that, Jagdish. Please answer, what is the word for second? A renewed what? Second blank. Yes, Priya, your answer is right. And one more student has written, Deepak Yadav. Correct. What is the second one? Enthusiasm. A renewed enthusiasm among wildlife lovers who see in it a potential. Potential what? Yes, Kumar, enthu is correct. Enthusiasm, that's what you meant. Please go to the third blank. What is the third one? Potential. Here, among wildlife lovers, enthusiasm, renewed enthusiasm among wildlife lovers who see in it a potential. Potential what? Also consider the word after the blank. You got 1, 2, 3. Now you should work on. You got 1 and 2. You should work on 3rd, 4th, and 5th. Third one, potential creeping is not correct. Bulwark, that is right. Prime, one more prime. So what is the third blank? Bulwark means what? A defensive wall. A defensive wall against. A potential defensive wall. A potential bulwark against. That is correct. What is the next one? Yes, a lot of students have responded, bulwark, that is correct. You have 2 words. Now you got exotic, you got enthusiasm, you got bulwark. Now you have 2. What is the next one? Yes, that is correct. Kumar, your answer is right. And creeping. Yes, Priya, that is correct. Priya Charan, that is right. Creeping is a word. What is it? Creeping. Pressures on. You're left with 1 word. What is that? Habitats. Very good. You have done well. How does the passage paragraph go? The Supreme Court's order enabling the introduction of exotic cheetahs. Look at the word after the blank, ask which part of speech, then think of the combination part of speech. Adjective, noun, one combination. Verb, adverb, one combination. To an Indian habitat on an experimental basis has naturally led to renewed enthusiasm among wildlife lovers who see in it a potential bulwark against creeping pressures on habitats. Wonderful. I appreciate you guys. Why I appreciate you guys, you have listened to me once and you've got exposed to this context for the first time. In spite of that, and I have not given enough time, in spite of that, you could answer almost all correct. That is highly appreciable. There's a parajumble, rather difficult, not that easy. Look at the parts very carefully. Yes, that is really highly appreciable. I mean it. This you need to spend a few, at least couple of minutes. But if you get the first sentence, it becomes easy for you to get the correct order. Usually I tell my students to take elimination approach when it comes to parajumble. Use that elimination approach, get the first sentence, then you can think of the continuity, the line of thought. Then you can get the correct order. Satish has written the synonyms, exotic, beautiful, location, that is right. Optimus Prime says the first sentence is D. Only one student has responded. I would like to wait for others also. This, I don't want to do it immediately. You need some time. Naidu also says D. I will do it definitely. Every day I will be doing it. Every day morning 7. The same day's editorial with exercises spontaneously. D is correct. What is the first one here? Let us see the correct order. D. While the court has appointed an expert committee to, always look at the last word in the part and think of the continuity. To what? To guide and direct. DE, that is correct. While the court has appointed an expert committee to guide and direct the experiment proposed by the National Tiger Conservation Authority. What is the next one? DE is correct. Oh, Ganesh has already given all the 5. One more student, Ravi also. That's wonderful. And Deepak Yadav. That's very good. So what is the next one? While the court has appointed an expert committee to guide and direct the experiment proposed by the National Tiger Conservation Authority, it needs, so where is the continuity? It needs, B is the next one. It needs a broader scientific inquiry into the added pressures that, what is the next one? A small group of introduced predators will impose on an ecosystem. C is the next one. Crucially on the prey base that currently sustains tigers and leopards. And what is the last one? DEBCA. AC is not correct. Excuse me. It should be. A is the last one. Oh, that is right, Ranjan. A lot of students have got it right. I appreciate all those students. So what is the correct order? DEBCA. The last sentence should be A. Now, spot the errors. From the editorial, I have taken 5 sentences, which are important from the exam point of view. Based on that, I have brought these sentences. Look at every sentence. Every sentence has an error related to grammar knowledge and try to spot the error. Think of tenses, active voice, passive voice, parts of speech, all these important topics that go with English grammar. Then try to spot the error. Already someone has responded, Optimus Prime. Oh, Ravi, already all the 5. That's really amazing. One is, oh, I think he's talking about the parajumble. Yes, Ravi, that is the correct order. Now work on spot the errors. Yes, Srinivas, that is correct. Please work on the errors. Sentence one, where is the error? First one is very important from the exam point of view. Where is the error? India misses its cheetahs. Its is a possessive pronoun. There's an important rule. What is that? Possessive pronoun never take an apostrophe. And when it comes to letter writing in our country, a lot of people close a letter, yours lovingly. Do remember, this is wrong. Yours is also a possessive pronoun. We can never use an apostrophe with possessive pronouns. So this is very important. You have to remember. Sentence number two, where is the error? Cheetah, a graceful animal, is hunted and extirpated in the country in the 20th century. Here, whenever you read a sentence, when it comes to spotting the errors, you should focus on the time phrase. What is the time phrase here? In the 21st century. Now we are in the 21st century. 20th century goes into the past. Then we cannot use the verb in present. So is not correct. It should be was. Cheetah, a graceful animal, was hunted. This is in past passive voice. You should always make a note. What is this about? First one is about pronouns, possessive pronouns. Second one is about past tense, passive voice. Where is the error? The third sentence. Last part not visible. Oh, I can't help it. I can see here. If you can see the first part of the sentence, you can spot the error. Yes, a lot of students have been responding. Third one, that is right. This talks about a contrasting. It is illogical to expect that a new population will fare good today than in the past. This is a bit difficult. There is a verb here, will fare. How does it fare? How will it fare? Then we should use an adverb, not an adjective. Here, good is an adjective. It is not correct. It should be well. It is illogical to expect that a new population will fare well today than in the past. Or here, not well, I'm sorry. Better. We should say better. Will fare better. How does it fare? Better. Comparative form. That is right. It is illogical to expect that a new population will fare better today than in the past. So, well, better, best. Adverb, adjective, good, adjective, well, adverb. But comparative and superlative, they have the same forms. Better, best. It will fare well today than in the past. Dan talks about the comparative form. Where is the error? Sentence number four. Any move to rewild India's threatened natural spaces with cheetahs should consider the viability of such a program. Farewell. Well is not correct. Better. I have corrected Optimus. Fare better. Please don't consider well. What I meant, the adverb is well, but we have to use a comparative form, better. I hope you got it. Where is the error? The next one. Now, better is over. Better than. Should consider, that is correct. Who is this? Optimus Prime, should consider. And Jesse also says considered is not correct. What is the reason? We have a helping verb here, should. Do remember, if you have to use a verb after the helping verb, any helping verb, that verb should be in bare infinitive. It should be in what? Bare infinitive. And here it is not in bare infinitive. Consider, we should not use considered. Should consider. Any move to rewild India's threatened natural spaces with cheetahs should consider the viability of such a program. Please don't use those expressions. Remember, bare infinitive. This is the right way to learn. Bare infinitive. man-animal conflicts are an area of concern. This is a bit difficult because the subject is in plural form. But it is presented a problem. Then we cannot say are, it should be is. You can cross-check in the editorial also. Man-animal conflicts is an area of concern. Is an area. You should focus on these two. We cannot say are an area. Is. I'm sorry about that. It looks like there's a problem with the fifth one. Don't worry, leave that one. You could answer four, be happy, and don't worry about the next one, the last one rather. Now, word map. There's one important word. The editorial starts with cat conundrum. That's an important word. Conundrum already have got the meaning. What are the related words? It means a difficult question, a puzzle, a riddle. Riddle also means puzzle, a mystery, enigma, something you cannot understand. But these words, they have other connotations. Generally, conundrum talks about a difficult question to understand, or a difficult puzzle, a difficult riddle, and a difficult problem to handle. Enigma, mystery, in a way, they go with this word, but they take other connotations. You should know the connotations and the usage also. Phrasal verbs based on the verb get. There are two phrasal verbs, more or less same meaning. One is get on with someone, get on with something, means have harmonious relationship. Get along also means the same thing. Are you getting on with your work? Do you get along with your brothers or sisters? These two mean one and the same. What is the next one? Get through. Get through means pass or assist someone to pass something difficult. Get through the exam, get through something, get through grammar questions. Then get over. This goes with health, illness. Get over your fever means overcome, come out of your fever. Get on, get along, one and the same. Get through, another meaning. Get over goes with health issues, illness. I got over my fever means what? I could come out of my fever. I overcame my fever. Get off. Get off, you all must be knowing, it goes with everyday English. Get off the bus, get down from the bus, one meaning. Get off, another meaning, it means to escape punishment. To escape punishment. To escape punishment, for that there is one idiomatic expression. To go scot-free. To go scot-free also means to escape punishment. That is an idiomatic expression, this is a phrasal verb. And what is the last one? Get round. Get round means convince someone or persuade someone to do something. Get round. Some of these are easy. Some of these are difficult. Get on with your work. Get on with something. Get along with someone. These are rather easy. They go with everyday English. Get through also goes with everyday English. It goes with exams or a difficult task. And get over. Those who are good at English, they know this one. Even this goes with everyday English. But get off, the regular meaning, a lot of people know. The second meaning, escape punishment, I doubt. So you should remember that one. Get round, to persuade someone, to convince someone. This is also not easy and it doesn't go with the word round. So you should try to remember those. Spend more time. From this editorial, in this editorial, you have got one idiomatic expression, cheek by jowl, means what? Close together. That is, cheek is a body part. Based on that, I have brought a few idioms related to body part. The second one, to turn a blind eye, to turn a blind eye to someone or something, means what? Pretend not to notice, one meaning. To ignore something that you know is wrong. You know something is wrong, you ignore that. Then what do we say? Turn a blind eye. Another meaning of turn a blind eye, pretend not to notice. He turned a blind eye to the existence of his enemy. He turned a blind eye to the existence of, to the presence of his enemy. He pretended not to notice. Give someone the cold shoulder. Usually this goes with public places or parties. Give someone the blind eye, keywords. Give the cold shoulder. Have an eye. To give someone the elbow. What does it mean? To tell someone to go away. She gave the elbow to her boyfriend because he lied. Means what? She told him to leave or go away, to give someone the elbow, to tell someone to go away. All these go with formal English. Some of these go with formal English and some of these go with informal English. You should know which one goes with formal English, which one goes with informal English. That is also equally important. Cheek by jowl, effect to English. Obviously, you got it in the editorial. So you should make a note. Don't stop with learning the meaning. You should know the usage. You should write F means what? Formal English and written English. Turn a blind eye. IF means what? Informal. Informal English. And give someone the cold shoulder. It goes with formal as well as informal. Have an eye on something. This also goes with informal English. Give someone the elbow. This goes with formal as well as informal. At the workplace, you could use it. And everyday English also, you could use it. What is the enrichment from today's editorial? You got about 10 or 15 effective words, definitely very useful from the exam point of view. You got about 5 phrasal verbs, 5 or 6 phrasal verbs, again important. You got 5 idioms based on body parts, very important. And these two go with effective English. Do remember, a lot of people speak English, but only a few get a lot of respect. What is the reason? Others think they speak effective English. What is the meaning of what goes with effective English? If you can use a lot of idioms, a lot of phrasal verbs, either when you speak or you write, then it is known as effective English. And that is respected and admired everywhere, even in the US, in the UK. In the US, in the UK, those who speak effective English, they get a lot of respect. Word map. You got conundrum, an important word. Based on that, you got the word map. Errors. You could work on 5 sentences related to errors. Tomorrow, I'll mention what they are about. That will help you retain. And in the long run, that will be useful. Close, you did extremely well. And parajumble, you did well. That's it for today. Hope you guys have enjoyed. Have a nice day. Tomorrow morning, again, sharp 7, tomorrow's editorial, and wait for the session so that you get enriched. Thank you very much. See you tomorrow with a new editorial.